Now, Channel 3 Early Warning Weather with meteorologist Mark Dixon.
Well, the hurricane season so far has been an active one across the Atlantic Basin. Historically speaking, based on averages, we typically get to our ninth named storm in early October. We've hit our ninth named storm in early August. So here's the latest update from NOAA and the National Hurricane Center. In that highlighted second column, you can see they're now calling for 19 to 25 tropical storms. That's when they get names, and of which 7 to 11 could become hurricanes, and of those, 3 to 6 could become major hurricanes, and that means Category 3 or stronger. So far this season, we've had 9 named storms, and of those, 2 have become hurricanes. So this is being described as what could be, of course, an extremely active season and one of potentially the busiest on record. And in that third column, you can see the average of 12, 6, and 3, respectively. So we'll of course keep you updated as conditions warrant as we head forward in time. But right now across the Atlantic Basin, including the Caribbean and the Gulf of Mexico, things are relatively quiet. With regard to our list of names, now that we've made our way through the ninth storm, Isaias, our next one, storm number 10, once that gets a name, we'll take on the name of Josephine. After that, Kyle, Laura, Marco, and then Nana. You can see the rest there. Now, if for instance, this forecast were to verify, we're able to get over, say, 21 named storms, we'll eventually go into the Greek alphabet. Again, things are quiet for right now, but the season starts on June 1st, runs through the end of November, and if you remember, it did get an earlier than expected start with development back in the month of May. So currently across the state here on this Thursday afternoon, we have temperatures as warm as 81 in New Haven, 80 in Norwich, 79 in Meriden, 72 though in Torrington, and 78 currently in Willimantic. Really comfortable out there, of course, because we've got dew point values in the 50s basically all across Connecticut, at least in many spots. Our view from Hartford showing we do have some filtered sun, mid and high level clouds out there, a little bit denser as we look live from our ICANN view from New Haven and as well from New London. Again, a few showers may clip coastal Connecticut. The really warm air has been pushed to our south, as well as the really muggy air. You see those shades of green and yellow, that's the more oppressive air mass. So we're going to continue to enjoy the break from the heat and humidity until probably late in the weekend and early next week. So we're tracking one disturbance that's moving offshore, could bring a couple showers or sprinkles to coastal Connecticut. Otherwise, we should see some sun mixing with the clouds this afternoon. Temperatures topping out near 80 along the shoreline, low 80s there, I should say, mid 80s, perhaps inland if we get enough sunshine. Here's Futurecast showing that wave moving out, a little clearing as we head toward this evening. Then more clouds move in tonight, and another wave of low pressure is going to ride to our south along a stalled frontal boundary. That's going to bring us perhaps a better chance for rain during the day tomorrow, some scattered showers. So temperatures tomorrow even cooler than today. And then for the upcoming weekend, not looking ideal as it once was for Saturday. It looks like a better chance now for rain, possibly some thunderstorms over the first half of the weekend, but then still on track for sunny, bright, and dry weather on Sunday, upper 80s, inland, mid 80s at the shoreline, still morning low temperatures in the 60s. Good for sleeping with the windows open if you don't have power. The next week, temperatures back to 90 or better inland with an uptick in humidity, and along the shoreline, eventually temperatures hit in the mid, if not upper 80s as well.